my name is Catalin. I'm the owner of POW in Chicago. We're going to go through some basic straight punches. So those are the first punches you should be learning when you're taking a boxing class. And hopefully you never get bored with them because they really define all the other punches that get added to them to build your combinations. Without really good straight punches, it's kind of hard to have fluid combinations and good footwork. So from here, I'm a big believer that everyone should learn a high and tight guard. That means essentially that your hands are very drawn in and close to your body. In fact, my arms rest on my body. I don't bring my elbows out, which makes me then have to hold my own arms up. By drawing my arms in, resting them on my body, my belly's a little bit more concave because I'm engaging my core. My right hand goes on the right side of my face, left hand on the left side, and about at my cheeks. Once your hands start coming underneath your chin, your punches are gonna start dropping really low, and you're no longer resting it on your body. Keep your weight a little bit in the center. You don't want to teeter-totter your weight. Even if you're doing this kind of box or bounce, you want to make sure that your weight stays between both legs. I'm a big believer in keeping that heel more elevated so that you have that kind of explosive power available to you all the time. Dropping your heel back is more of a posture that has to do with defense. So if we're focused on striking, particularly straight punches, which is the jab and the cross, or the 1-2, you want to keep your body weight fairly centered. To get a little weight behind your jab, you want to make sure that you step into it. As you step into it, you're still going to keep weight in that back leg. So avoid teeter-totter. As the punch goes out, the palm turns down, the label goes up on the glove. I bring it back to my cheekbones, which also helps me punch higher. As I throw my cross, that chain of movement begins off my legs, and my legs throw that punch. As I throw that movement, my head remains back. So be careful with the rotation that you're not throwing your head all the way in front or past the knee of your front leg. When you put them together, my body is always pulling the punch back. And my abs are engaged for that right cross, and then my abs continue to stay engaged as I draw my punches back. So those are some basic tips for a solid fighting stance for boxing, as well as your basic straight punches. Hopefully you enjoyed that and you got a lot out of it in just a few minutes that we went through.